Hi, Rishabh. Good morning.
Hey, hi Nancy. Hi everyone. Good morning.
I've started the recording, Rani. Let's start there.
Nancy, can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Fantastic. Okay. Can you hear us? Once more, say something. One, two, three.
Hey, Saurav. We can hear you. Are you able to hear us?
Good to go.
You!
Awesome.
Okay, let's get started then.
Ladies, stop taking your own pictures. Take someone else's. You guys can't speak.
I'll pause the recording for now unless we start.
Good morning, guests and fellow Toastmasters. A very warm welcome to the Gabbys 100th meeting. It's the second year celebration today. Congratulations, Gabbys. Every Toastmaster has a mission, and our mission is to provide a mutually supportive and positive learning environment in which every member has the opportunity to develop communication and leadership skill, which in turn foster self-confidence and personal growth. I'm Toastmaster Nishi, your sergeant at arms for today's meeting. Before we start the meeting, let me clear some key points. Toastmasters present online, joined as a online meeting today. We want you to mute your audio and unmute only when you are asked to or need to talk. Please keep your video on because we want your participation here. Offline members, may I now request everyone to put your phones to silent because we want uninterrupted meeting and we want your full attention towards us. Topics on sex, religion, and politics, even Toastmasters International, does not put any restriction on speaking on such topics, but at Gabbys, we will appreciate if you kind of be mindful of speaking on these topics. Finally, every Toastmaster is reminded of the Toastmasters pledge that we had taken when we had joined the Toastmasters club to uphold the organization's value of respect, integrity, excellence at all times. Moving on, from July to December 2021, at the start of almost every Gabbys meeting, these simple words, moving on, brought a smile on many of faces, Toastmasters and guests. Simple words, but the eloquence and elegance that the voice carried added an effect that hard to emulate. With the same elegance, she leads our club today, and it's under her leadership that the club is going strength to strength this year. So moving on from a sergeant at arms to the club president of the Gabbys, an yoga enthusiast, a soft skill trainer, an eloquent speaker, and a presiding officer for our 100th meeting today. Give it up for Toastmaster Ritu George.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nishi, for a fantastic introduction. Moving on. We hoped at first we could travel light. A decent cloak, a staff, a hat with fur. For we were young and light of heart and bold. But on the way, the backpack seemed to expand with souvenirs and mementos, with goals and spearheads, with words of love and kindness, and memoirs and talismans. And finally, the mom. Yes, for us, the Gabbys is a mer. That's something special, that factor. That's what makes us, our lives more happening, more memorable. But when this all started, and though I wasn't a part of this, I say that now, and I speak for them, the 23 charter members of the Gabbys who started this magic. The best part is today on the 100th meeting, 2 years hence, I rise to thank them all. We are because you are. I hereby declare the meeting number 100 of the Gabbys Toastmaster Club as open. I hereby call the meeting to order. Let me first welcome all the members and the guests, Toastmasters, distinguished Toastmasters, and leaders to our community, to our meeting. Thank you for being here on this milestone meeting, our second birthday, our 100th meeting, and thank you for your support through these 2 years. The mission of our club is to provide a positive and supportive learning environment to every member. At the Gabbys, we do that with the three E's: excellence, empathy, and enthusiasm. Now, let me introduce the 40, elegance. Before moving forward, let me welcome our first performer for today. She is the past Vice President Public Relations of the Gabbys. She's a pathbreaker and a contest winner at area and division levels. She has mesmerized us with her speeches, and today she's here to enthrall us with her grace, passion, and elegance. Put your hands together and let's welcome Toastmaster Lakshmi Sujata, our first performer of the day. Today. We have seven new members who have joined our family very recently. Let me reach out to them. There's Toastmaster Chaitanya, Sayad, Govardhan, Supriya, Nagesh, Bala, and Vijaya. Thank you for choosing Gabbys as your learning partner and us as your family going forward. Wish you a fantastic journey ahead. Which means the Super Club of 2021 has bagged Smedley Membership Awards yet again and one DCP point from membership, standing one member away from those five DCP points. That's going to happen soon, very soon. A big shout out to my trio, Toastmaster Reena, our Vice President, Membership, Toastmaster Preeti, getting us the four DCP points within 3 months of the New Year program. Now, let's hear from the district leadership team of District 92. We are a proud member of Area B1, District 92, and the home club of our division director, distinguished Toastmaster Saurabh Datta. Past and present area directors. Today we have amongst us several district officers. May I invite DTM Rishabh Mehta, our district director, to come forward and say a couple of words of encouragement, I would say. Are you here with us, DTM Rishabh? Is DTM Rishabh with us?
Ritu, I'm not able to see him on screen right now.
All right.
He was there.
He was
right
there.
Now, yes, he was there.
Wait for him to maybe come back. Is DTM Rohit with us? Rohit Koka?
Rohit hasn't joined. I got a message from DTM Rishabh. He said power lost happened and trying to join again.
Okay. When he's back, please do let us know. We would love to hear his 2 cents. And of course, encouragement for our club members. All right. Well, I'm sure he only had good things to say. Let's just move on from there. But public relations is finding the right home for unique narratives. That's how we look at PR. And take it really seriously. Hence, the Gabbys won the Promote Award last year, recognition of our strong public relations strategy. And two of the most important PR vehicles for a Toastmasters club are our newsletter and the guest booklet. So here's that big moment that all the Gabbys have been waiting for. Launching of the Gabbys newsletter for the term July to December 2022 and the Gabbys guest booklet. May I invite our Vice President Public Relations, Toastmaster Aparna Raja, to take the stage and do the honors.
Thank you very much, and good morning, everyone. So here we are, finally. We put together a newsletter again, and it is a Ubuntu, but this time it's Ubuntu 4.0. My fantastic team, comprising of Toastmaster Sri Lakshmi, Toastmaster Vikram, Toastmaster Karthik, Toastmaster Saurabh, and Toastmaster Sushmita Baidya, worked hard, very hard, for over a month to collect the features, the articles, and whatnot. And I must say, we put together a fairly good newsletter, but more of that very soon. Let's call upon the special person who's made all the way to the venue today to launch our newsletter. May I invite our area B1 director, Toastmaster Prerna, to please come forward and launch the newsletter.
Good morning, everyone. I am actually very speechless today coming to the Gabbys meeting. I am not having the right words to express how I'm feeling today. I mean, I should say that I'm very lucky that I have Gabbys under my area. When I became the area director, I had 5 clubs under me. And I don't know, for some reason, I never had to think about Gabbys. And I questioned to myself, why is it so? And the answer was, like, I have trust and so much of trust and faith. And why was it trust and faith there? Because I could see that action in this club. I feel that in Gabbys, action speaks louder than words, and you people do what you speak. So congratulations to everyone here for the second. So the Gabbys newsletter is out today. Congratulations, everyone.
The flip book.
So this is launched?
Yes. We're launching the flip book.
Oh, watch out. I'll launch it, but I can't. You have to go on screen share. This,
okay, that's the flip book. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Prerna. So that was the newsletter, and I hope the online folks got to see the flipbook as well. I would now like to call upon the AD one more time to launch our guest booklet.
Congratulations, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. So we will be mailing you all the soft copy as well, very soon, the online folks. Don't fret. Thank you very much. I'm the VBPR of the Gabbys, and now I'm handing back the control to our resident Toastmaster. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Thank you, Toastmaster Prerna. Thank you for this fabulous launch and a big, big moment for us. Let's move on. Let's continue the party, isn't it? Let's welcome our Toastmaster for the day. Toastmaster Preeti Pranav Jain. She is the Vice President, Education of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club. Toastmaster Preeti, the stage is all yours. Take it on, dazzle and shine. Thank you, Madam President, Toastmaster Ritu George. The more you celebrate life, the more life gives you opportunities to celebrate. And today, we are celebrating the big day of the Gabbys, for the Gabbys, by the Gabbys, and with the Gabbys. And with the Gabbys, our friends from within and beyond the Toastmasters fraternity. So a big round of applause for each and everyone present here and here. All know today is a different meeting, not a regular one. We are all decked up. It's a celebration day. So today, a chutti from GE evaluation and the toughest of grammarians from the Gabbys, who are famous for their grammar reports, isn't it? So just give a big woohoo! I request everyone present here, be it online or offline, to just stand up in your places, please, because we need a big round of applause to energize ourselves. We are sitting in front of the system since long. So start clapping. Come on. Yes. Very good. And now, I thank everyone for giving me the standing ovation. I just can't wait till the end, right? Yes, I'm smart. Thank you very much for they're telling me it's a smart move. I believe so are you, because I can't wait till the end of the session. I don't know what will happen. So with this, let's do something interesting today. Yes, you have seen the members in Gabbys. You know them as the best grammarian, as the best GE. You know as a DTM or the evaluator or the district champions, but now is your chance to recognize your own family members. And let's see whether you are able to do that or not. Are you all ready for that?
Yes.
So I'll request Toastmaster Nancy, just play first one.
DTM Rishabh is back.
Okay, I just got to know that DTM Rishabh is back. He's with us. So may I request DTM Rishabh to just speak some lines, few lines for us.
Well, thank you so much, Madam Host. And it is a spot that you have put me into. I've just entered the meeting room and I've been asked to speak. And more importantly, nice things as quoted by Madam Host. But good morning, everyone. It's been two years that the Gabbys Toastmasters Club came into inception, and what a wonderful 2 years this has been for the members, for the guests, for the leaders that the Toastmasters, that the Gabbys Toastmasters Club has been provided to District 92 and beyond. The Gabbys Club was incepted and was chartered 2 years back in a completely online setup. And while most of the clubs around the globe were struggling to have their meetings online, here came a club And mind you, a brand new club with enthusiastic 22 odd members who wanted to keep ensuring that they are sticking to basics. Here was a brand new club who wanted to ensure that they are just restricting themselves to the Bible that's there and not really restricting themselves to the creativity that the members could bring in. Here was a club who wanted to make sure that the members around don't really look at how long the Gabbys Club have been around, but they wanted to make sure that the members around feel that regardless of whether they are 1 meeting old, 1 month old, or 1 year old, here is a club that you should be attending the meeting. Here is a club that's ready to make a difference, and here is a club that can add value to the 2 hours that you'll take out from your schedule attending the meeting at the Gabbys. The last 2 years have just gone in a jiffy, and we have seen multiple leaders stepping out of the club, the area, the division, the district for that matter, and helping members and clubs all around, mentoring clubs and in district and all around. Thank you so much to the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, the wonderful leadership that you have, the mentoring that you are doing internally and beyond, the guidance that you're providing internally and beyond, and everything that you're doing to make sure that we as an organization, that we as a community keep growing. Wishing the members of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club a very happy birthday. 2 years old, but 2 years younger, I feel, because there's still a lot more for us to go. The 100th meeting milestone is another cherry on the cake, as they say, that regardless of 100th meeting or the 99th meeting that we just had or the 100th meeting that's going to upcome, here is a club that's going to make sure that the value in every single meeting is top-notch. So while we do celebrate the 100th meeting today, and everything today is about celebrations, let's ensure that we keep providing this value to our members, to our guests, every single week, every single meeting, every single moment that we have. Thank you so much once again for the opportunity, and I wishing all the very best to the club, to the members, to the guests, for a fantastic year ahead and a fantastic journey in your journeys. Thank you so much, and back to Madam Host.
Thank you very much, DTM Rishabh. And I must say, we must be newborns. But you know, the day Gabbys took birth, it didn't do, wah! It just did, yeah, I'm here. Trust me. And it's 2 years. All the awards we have, it shows what we have done here. We are the Gabbyites. Yes. And to begin our session with a bang, let's recognize our own family members. Many of us are meeting them for the first time offline. And here is something interesting. I'm going to show you their pictures. And you have to recognize who are they, who among from your family. And I'll request Toastmaster Nancy to play the very first picture. So before doing that, I'll request all the members present here. If you want, you can log in from your mobile too. And just tell me, who is going to give the answer? Who is he, the gentleman?
Amit.
He is Toastmaster Amit.
One quick question, Preeti, here. Are you able to see the name at the top, or is it just a picture when I'm sharing my screen?
I can see the name also. The name.
Oh my God. Okay, so whosoever has shared these pictures has shared the names as well. How do I hide these names? Tell me. Is it visible now as well?
Yes, actually. So, if you would have not told, nobody would have noticed it. Okay, so start showing. Others will just guess. Be honest, guys. Okay, follow some ethics, self-assessment. Okay, don't do cheating. Who is this gorgeous lady? From online, who wants to answer this? Who is she?
Aparna. I can still see the name.
Who is answering this?
Chaitanya.
Hi, Chaitanya. Thank you very much. You can see the name, but I told you, be honest. Don't see the name.
I can't be that honest if it is.
Can't be. Okay. So, yeah, we'll keep playing it quickly because they are able to see the names. The cutest. This is our darling secretary, whom we are missing very badly here, Thwani. Offline. Thwani, Toastmaster Thwani Adhisara.
Preeti.
No.
Dolly.
You are not supposed to answer, Toastmaster. Aparna, you know everyone.
But the names are there.
But still.
I haven't seen the names.
It's Dolly.
Dolly. Okay,
someone
next.
Sorry. I saw the name, but I'll not answer.
Let someone from online answer this.
Preeti.
No, not Preeti. Someone from online.
I couldn't guess who it was. The name is there, but come to say.
Toastmaster Karthik.
Okay.
Karthik calling Karthik. Right. Next.
Okay.
Toastmaster Nishi is saying, "Bahut hi pyara bachcha hai. Kaun hai
ye?" Is this Nishi?
Oh, not Nishi. Okay, again Karthik. Next, quickly. We don't have time, so we'll go a little faster.
Okay.
Yes, please. The gorgeous little girl.
Lakshmi.
Yes,
Lakshmi.
I think hers only. Yes. This is no other than our dancer, the beautiful soul, Toastmaster Lakshmi Sujata. Yes.
Now you have to guess which Preeti is this. No, this is Preeti Jain.
Yes, it's me with my dad. Thank you very much. Yes, I was born in black and white period. So this is the compliment I just now received, that I was born in black and white era, and I'm proud of it. Yes. You will agree with me. I maintain myself pretty well, isn't it? Is this someone, Mrs. India? Is it Mrs. India? Yes, Mrs. India, Reena.
Shri Lakshmi.
Shri Lakshmi.
They all look the same.
They all look the same, right?
Srishti.
Okay, the names are there. We'll go quickly. Come on, keep telling. Sushmita, Toastmaster Sushmita, and we are missing her today in offline meeting. Of course, it's Vikram, our guitarist.
Which one is Vikram here? The left one or the right one?
The taller one.
Smaller one. Smaller one.
One. Okay, the Chotu one. Okay.
Okay. I think that's all.
Yes. Yes. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Nancy. As I said, it's a different meeting. It's a celebration time. And when do you see the maximum energy during a regular Toastmasters meeting? During the table topic session. Right. We all feel at ease and free. So today, for a change, we are having 4 table topic sections. No speeches, no evaluation, no grammar at all. So was that fun, guys? The pictures?
Yes.
Time to take the fun notches up with the first round of table topics. For this section, we have 2 timers, one online, Toastmaster Rani Jindal, another offline, Toastmaster Sri Lakshmi. For these impromptu speeches, we will follow the same timing protocol. Green at 60 seconds, yellow at 90 seconds, red at 2 minutes. Plus, you can take a bonus of 30 seconds extra, which you should use judiciously to help us stay on time, right? And for doing that, we have someone who has taken up our club, not notches up, but light years ahead, the first president of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, and the currently the Educom lead of District 92. Soon to be distinguished Toastmaster Nancy Goel. Toastmaster Nancy Goel, our first TTM for today. Over to you, Toastmaster Nancy Goel.
Thank you so much. Just a minute. Good morning. I'm Nancy from the Gabbys News. Let's look at the emotions and feelings report for the club today. morning, it was boring and mundane. Now, it's exuberating, fun, and frolic. I just lost my teleprompter. And it was so mundane to just look at the teleprompter and speak. I can't do that. It's very difficult to be a news reporter. But as difficult as it is, it's fun too. And to have this fun with all of you, I'm just taking the notch of this table topic session a little higher. So what we are going to do, I'll give you a news. Yes. Keep a look at my screen at the back. I'll read the topic for you, but still, you'll get the hint from the virtual background. I'll call you up. 1 to 2 minutes is all yours. You can be as bland as I was, or you can be as sensational as the Prime TV news. So who's going to be my first volunteer? Let me call upon somebody from offline people. May I request Prerna to take it up? Come on, Prerna. Prerna, are you all set?
Yeah.
Your topic is this.
Oh my god.
Are you able to read? I'll read it for you. DTM Saurabhdatta left Gabbys. That's your topic. He didn't renew from the Gabbys. Yes, that's your topic.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nancy, for the topic. The topic is really interesting. DTM Saurabhdatta didn't renew in Gabbys. Now, I would like to get help from the audience here. I want to ask the audience here, since the members know Saurabhdatta more than me, so I want to ask, what are the reasons Saurabh will not renew in Gabbys?
He's moved abroad.
So this breaking news is actually not true. I think the news reporter needs to check the news channel and get the correct information, because Saurabhdatta will never leave Gabbys Toastmasters Club. He's like the father of Gabbys Toastmasters Club, like he always says. And this news is not true. And you can see from the audience response that I don't think so anyone will believe. It's unbelievable. So I would request you to go back and check the information and get the correct one. Because as long as Saurabh is there, Gabbys is alive. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Prerna, for a wonderful take on the topic. Remind you that you are the news reporter, not me. So you have to speak like a news reporter. This is the news I'm giving you. Let me call upon the next the scapegoat for the second table topic. Somebody from online folks, may I request Dhwani? Dhwani, are you there?
Hey, yes, I'm there.
Dhwani, I would request you to turn on your camera and your topic is this.
I cannot see. Could you? Okay. Aliens heard discussing Gabbys.
So it's not just the word, it's the aliens now speaking about the Gabbys. Over to you.
Okay. Yes, so sorry for that, staying at home. Aliens heard about Gabbys. I'm actually thinking what to say, because Gabbys, I think, is everywhere. We are a club that we, you know, the kids who come, who are very smart, and the kids who are always sitting on the first bench, that's Gabbys. We are kids who are always there everywhere in the first bench, being such an obedient child, such an obedient person, that in fact, even aliens, if they come and visit us, they'll be like, this club is good. I need to go to this club because there's something about this club. And if aliens heard about Gabbys, then of course, I mean, it's something very out of the box. But we are people who give our 100% and we dedicate ourselves to the club so much that we always have meetings which are out of the box. So that's my take on it. And thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Dhwani. I'm sure it's fun that it's not just the world who's talking about smart kids of the Gabbys, as you mentioned, but it's now the aliens. The news has spread wide far. All right, moving on to the next speaker. Let's go back to the offline people here. Do we have DTM Saurav Datta?
Right here, ma'am.
Okay. Here's your topic. First day, remember, you are the news reporter. First day of the term, they nailed it again. 9 DCP.
Toastmasters, leaders from across the world, I have a breaking news for you. The Gabbys has nailed it again. 9 DCP points, and this is just the first day of the exam. That was a fake news. Right? It can only be possible if you are stalling all your education awards to file them on 1st of July of the next year. That is something the Gabbys will never ever do. The Gabbys believes in winning, playing the right way, winning the right way, bringing things home. Let me give you one example that I've heard when I was speaking to the club president today. I was asking her and what's about this fake news. And she said, if that is something we would be doing, we would have been a distinguished club by now. 5 DCP points would have been in our kit. I said, come on, how? She said, because we did have a few people who had left our club and they can join back just for the month of September. We can have them in, get the 8th new member, get the 2nd DCP point from membership, get the 5 DCP points and claim to be a DCP club. But we decided not to, because this is not the Gabbys way. This is not the way where we try to cut corners, find loopholes, find ways and means to get things done the easier way. Because doing things the Gabbys way takes time, takes effort. Wow, that's inspirational, Madam President. That was the only reaction I could give her. And I was totally sold to this fact that the Gabbys can never have 9 DCP points on the day one of the term, because that is not the Toastmasters way. Signing off, over to you, Madam Nancy.
Thank you, distinguished Toastmaster Saurav Datta, for calling it out of fake news. Oh my God. I need to work on my news now. May I request one of the online members here? Let's call. Yes, I can see a raise of hand. Marutesh.
Yeah, hello.
Okay, Marutesh, your topic is Matt Kinsey wants to join Gabbys. Matt Kinsey is international president, Toastmasters international president.
Yeah, Patan, can you repeat it? Yeah.
Matt Kinsey wants to join the Gabbys. Easy. International president.
Okay. Yeah, I want to talk. How I want to talk? Like,
you
I'm a president.
Talk, you can talk as a news reporter because this is a news.
Okay.
Just go ahead. What if you get to know that, yes, there's the international president who wants to join a club?
Okay. Sorry, and I will go next. I'm not getting correctly.
No problem. We'll come back to you in the next table topic section. All right, Suhan, over to you. You can take this one.
Okay, so you can hear me, right? And you can see me also, right? Yeah. All right. Greetings to you all from Kuwait. This is Toastmaster Suhan Abdul Munaf reporting live. Yeah, it's one of the great news that I have received that Matt Kinsey wants to join Gabby's Toastmasters Club. It is indeed one of the greatest moment for him to join this club, because this club has been achieving lots and lots of what do I call you? I mean, you all have got lots of trophies and DCP points, and that's what might have impressed Matt McKenzie. But Table Topic Master, there's something that I need to tell you. Actually, I had met Matt McKenzie and I have told him, why do you need to join Gabby's Toastmasters Club? Because there is someone in Kuwait who is from Desert Pioneers Toastmasters Club. It is one of the best districts, one of the best clubs in one of the best districts, in one of the best region, in one of the best Toastmasters Club in Kuwait. Why don't you join us? Because it's one of the other news that I have received from my insider, saying that he might consider joining Gabby's because he wants to join Desert Pioneers Toastmasters Club. So I won't confirm this news until unless I receive his membership fees from your other side. So we have to wait and watch. So I'm signing off as Toastmaster Suhan Abdul Munaf from Kuwait, and back to you, Toastmaster Nancy.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Suhan, for such a fun and interesting take on the topic. I'm sure it's going to be a fight. Which club does he join? Let's wait for it. Thank you once again. Let me call upon my next speaker, and this time, offline one. May I request Toastmaster Reena to take up the stage?
Reena's not here, Nancy.
Okay, Ritu, would you like to take this up?
Me?
Yes, Ritu.
Okay, sure, why not? Where's the mic?
You don't need a mic. You can speak like this.
I know I'm loud, but I'm a reporter. Go on.
Yes, you are a reporter. And the breaking news for this reporter, Toastmaster Ritu, is Mrs. I'm Beautiful to VPM of the Gabbys. Mrs. I'm Beautiful to the VPM of the Gabbys.
Yes, okay. Okay, yes, Sora. What? Oh, really? No. Really? Oh my God, I'm getting breaking news right now. We have our Mrs. India, I'm Beautiful. You see her on the screen right now? Yes, that one. Unbelievable, she's joined hands with the Gabbys. It's a breaking news. The whole country is in shock. And we are too. Miss Beautiful joining Gabbys. What a transformation. It's like, she's joining BJP or something. It's one of those things I'm seeing, Gabbys, and not just joining, she's been given a coveted position also. You will not believe, it's vice president membership. It's the trio, and she's amongst the first top three members. Not just she's part of the team, but she's also been given a very high ranking position in the club. One second, I'm getting some more breaking news. Yes? Okay. Oh my God, I think she's eyeing for the president position right now. We're hearing, my correspondent got in touch with her PR agent, and she's saying, okay, I'm getting one more news. Sorry, one second. Okay. This one is not confirmed. I don't want to sensationalize anymore. She is going to run for the president next time, and that's confirmed. That's it. That's it from me. Back to the studios. Thank you. That'll be from me, Ritu George.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was our face turning sensational all of a sudden. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ritu, for such a sensational take on the topic. And my dear Gabbys and our guests, I am Nancy from the Gabbys News. Thanks for reporting. Good day to you too. Bye-bye. Over to you, Toastmaster Priti.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nancy. Wasn't it sensational? The topics, oh my God. We could not have got better than this. Isn't it? We all agree. Superb. Now, moving ahead. Life is like a music. Some high notes, some low notes, but always a good song. Let us now invite our immediate past VP Public Relations, a proud ambassador of everything pink, Toastmaster Vikram Rao, and someone accompanying Toastmaster Vikram Rao is his guitar. So welcome, Toastmaster Vikram Rao.
Good morning, everybody. It's great to be here at the 100th meeting of the Gabbys. It's been such a splendid meeting. We just heard some fabulous breaking news from Toastmaster Ritu and totally aced it, Ritu. I'm going to sing two songs for all of you. One is going to be a song from Silk Route. Have you all heard of Silk Route?
Yes!
Okay. And the other is going to be from John Denver. So both are my favorite songs. And the first one I used to sing for my sweetheart in college, because she used to like this a lot.
Come on, man.
Okay.
Because she used to like it so much.
So this the other song I'm going to sing is called Leaving on a Jet Plane.
Oh, lovely!
From John Denver, yeah. One of my favorite songs. And if you know, you can sing along. It's a very nice, charming song.
Toastmaster, a past district officer, two times path breaker, winner in all formats of the contest at an area or division level, logging in all the way from Singapore, Toastmaster Bala Venkat. Toastmaster Bala Venkat, over to you for conducting the next table topic section.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Hello, Gabbys. Are we all having fun? Are you enjoying?
Yes.
Yes, yes, yes. Great, great, great to know that you are all moving on and you're having fun, grooving with Vikram. Great dance, great celebrations indeed. So I was thinking from a table topic session, you know, I'm always, in fact, in the newsletter, I've talked about choices that we make in our life. I always believe it's the choices that determines your success. Your decisions in your life always comes from those choices. So I thought, why not have a theme around that today? So what I mean by that is, let's take an example. So one of the questions could be, what do you like the most? Do you love the lunch or the dinner? And you can bring in a story saying, yeah, I love to have lunch with my colleagues. It's a great, normally most of the time, I'm in the office having lunch, but you know what? when I go back to family, the dinner is a family time. Makes me feel being part of the family. So something like that. So very simple topics I'm coming up with. Feel free to participate, share your stories, my friends. So with that, let me call upon the first volunteer from online. Sonia, are you okay to try first? Sonia, are you there?
Yes, team.
Okay, great. So your topic, Sonia, is what is more important to be successful in life? Good luck or hard work? Good luck or hard work?
I would like to ask you all, what is more important, day or night? Water or food? So anyone can give answer. I know. You all will say that they both are equally important because no one can survive with only water, without food. And no one can even survive only with food and without water. So that is why. Similarly, if we say day or night, if every time it will be day, so we will not be able to see the beauty of the night, the stars, the moon, the beautiful calmness. And we will not be able to, if only night will be there, we will not be able to see the beauty.
Sorry, did we lose Sonia?
Yes, her video is
closed. I think we just lost her. So we'll continue with the next one, but we'll wait for Sonia to come back. All right. Okay, so moving on. Let me try.
She's back.
She's back? Okay.
Actually, there is internet problem, but no problem. Okay, sorry. So I'm repeating, day and night, both are equally important. Food and water, both are equally important. Similarly, hard work and good luck, both are equally important. See, we cannot say any by looking anyone. There are so many details sitting, like if we talk about the Toastmasters only. So this is a great achievement in this platform. We cannot say that they are lucky. That's why they are like that. We have not seen the hard work which is behind that for reaching at that particular position, what hard work they have put, that is equally important. So luck, we all are lucky because we have got the opportunity to come in the Toastmasters. And this is our luck, but it is our hard work. If we want to achieve some great heights by learning good speaking skills and leadership skills, so for that we have to put our efforts, we have to put our hard work. So that is why if both things are equally important, hard work as well as luck. Let me tell you one thing, we have seen the duck is so beautiful, so pretty. And if you will look at the duck when it is swimming on the water surface, so we can see only from the outside and we'll say, oh, she's not doing any hard work, she's so lucky that she is able to swim in the water. But when we will go deep into the water and we will see the whatever we call the foot of the duck, I don't know, so that will say she's doing so much of efforts to swim, so that is not visible to us from the front. So luck as well as hard work both go together. Same thing, a scooter cannot move without the front wheel or the back wheel. So both wheels are equally important. Back to the table topic master, TM Pala.
Hey, thank you, Sonia. Thanks. Give her a round of applause. In fact, when you talk about the duck, actually my legs are shaking at the moment, but I'm trying to project that everything is okay out here. All right, so let's get to the next volunteer, or maybe somebody from in person. Aparna, do you want to give a try?
Yes, I think I'll.
Okay, thanks, Aparna. So your topic, what makes you stronger, success or failure? What makes you stronger, success or failure?
Finally, I've had the opportunity to ask you all this question face to face. You can't lie. You can't turn off your camera, at least the offline folks. So tell me, what do you think makes you stronger?
For me, success.
Success?
Failure? A part of both.
So that is the answer, Toastmaster Bala. I think a part of both. And for me personally, looking back, I think it has been those moments when I failed, it made me stronger. As cliche as it may sound, the more you hit the steel when it is hot, they say it comes out sharper. And I believe that applies the steel of the iron. That applies pretty much to life and all of us here. The more you're under duress, the more you are under pressure, the more you're tested and you think, oh my God, I'm gonna break. God be like, you make it out of it. I think you're probably the strongest person in the room. And going by that, I've been through my share of downs as well. So I think the failures, as bitter, as horrible, as unwanted as it may sound to us, that is what makes us stronger. If you want to accept it or not, doesn't matter. That is the truth and the only truth, according to me. Back to you, Toastmaster Bala.
Thank you, Aparna. Indeed, success and failure are both sides of the same coin, isn't it? We learn from both these experiences. Thank you. Now to the next topic of Marutesh, do you want to give it a try now? Are you okay to give it a
try? Yeah.
Okay, good. And your topic, Marutesh, is what is more powerful to you, love or money? What is more powerful to you, love or money?
Thank you, Tabletop Master. Yeah, if you see in relationship, love is more powerful. When we love our parents, our neighbors, our sisters, really that will not come with money, because money we can earn anytime, but we can spoil our relationship, spoil our love, will not accept, people will not accept. Hence, most powerful is I go for love. I remember in my college days, I used to have some good relationship with my friends. They have showed so much of encouragement in that time. Like this, based on their attitude, love will come with other, or relationship will come with other. But money is in different aspect. Money only buy the physical commodities, but it can't buy love or relationship or personality. Like this, love and inner thing is very important for a person. Thank you. Back to Tabletop.
Hey, thank you, Maritesh, for sharing that. Yeah, totally agree with all your points. Gabbys, are you all in? Are you in? How many of you are active, inactive at the moment? Active or inactive? If you're all active, say yes. Okay, great. Okay. Just wanted to make sure that. Okay, moving on just to the next participant from the in-person. Preeti Jain, do you want to give it a try? Preeti.
Toastmaster Bala, may I request something?
Yeah, sure.
So I have taken a lot of stage. I'll request you to call someone else from offline.
I'm okay. Sure. Why don't you nominate one?
Maybe on my side, my better half. Will that do?
Absolutely.
Sure. Both. So then I'm inviting Ravi Jain.
Okay. Ravi Jain, great to have you here. Wonderful. And your topic for is, what is success to you? Power or fame? What is success to you? Power or fame? Over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Bala. I'm really feeling on the spot, but the choices you gave, actually, I would like to have both power as well as fame. And not only that, much more than that, beyond it, because I think fame automatically comes with power if you utilize it properly, right? Otherwise, there is a management saying that power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely. But if you really make use of it ethically, then you know it can get you a good fame, not a defame. For success for me is both. But it is actually beyond both of these things because, and we saw currently the humanity suffered because of the corona and all of that. And we know that life is so short, right? So in a moment's time, we can be no more from Mr. Ravi Jain to I can become a body instantly, right? In next second. So I think to me, to help my fellow human beings, help them motivate, help them, feel. So those who are kind of struggling in any field, be it health, be it their, career, be it any other things. So to support your fellow human beings, help them grow, make them, feel good and enjoy life 100%. The fact that we have come into this shape and size, like a human being, they say that this is the best avatar, right? So we have 84,000 yonis in, and we have traveled all of that, and now we are in the best form. This is the form where we have our wisdom, because all other forms doesn't have wisdom, right? So to make fullest use of this avatar is also one thing which to me means success, right? So I would appeal to all you all that don't just get limited by your mundane worldly things for success, but I think beyond that, and that should be success to me and to all of us. Thank you.
Thanks, Ravi. Round of applause to Ravi Jain. What a Ravi, I think we need to connect. We need to talk a lot more deeper in this philosophically, okay? I'm going to actually connect with you separately. Thanks for sharing that wisdom to all of us. Going to the next topic, I see a hand raised. Hadrian Larson, are you okay to take it up?
This is my first Toastmasters meeting, so I think I can give it a shot.
No, that's it's perfect then. You're the perfect candidate. Obviously, okay. So your topic, Hadrian, is what is more valuable to you, education or experience? What is more valuable to you, education or experience?
Well, I think to start with, everyone needs a foundation. And a lot of people before education, there was always experience. And experience built the foundation of education. So I think education is being vital as it is. Experience can speak for itself when it is targeted at a certain aspect of anything we do. And this might sound a bit dark, Take all the people who ruined the world, Adolf Hitler and Pablo Escobar. They took experience and they caused so much chaos, which made a lot of people get have some awareness of what they did. I mean, like, they put a lot of people under a coffin and 6 feet under. So, but the people and the generations born after them got to know and be educated of their massacre. But coming back to the topic, I think education is important, but not as important as experience, because experience inspires education to create new and important sources of material to learn and better improve ourselves in the future. Thank you, Toastmaster Bala, for this opportunity.
Thank you very much. It didn't look like it's the first time you're talking. You know, great going.
Toastmaster Bala, let's close the session here.
All right. Thank you very much for all of your participation. Go on, celebrate the Gabbys with the Gabbys. Back to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
It was indeed amazing table topic session. Thank you very much, Toastmaster Bala. Now, how is the energy? Are you ready for something very different?
Yes.
And I just want to Jalwa, jalwa. Fashion ka hai ye jalwa, jalwa. Yes, fashion does have its own charm, its own jalwa. And we bring that jalwa right here today. So please put your hands together to welcome the studs and the queens of the Gabbys as they step into this to set the ramp on fire. Clap for them.
Second anniversary.
today.
They deserve it, isn't it? They all wanted to take a group picture and let them do that for a moment.
Hey, pause, pause. What is this? Pause.
I would request each and everyone present online to unmute yourself and clap for our gorgeous studs and queens. Come on, they really deserve a big round of applause. Aren't they looking gorgeous?
Yes.
So that was the Gabbys on the ramp. A big, big round of applause for Toastmaster Amit Gupta. So I'll request you, 1 second. Can you bring him in the camera, please? Amit Gupta. Just say hi, guys. So here is Toastmaster Amit Gupta. Toastmaster Dolly Krishnappa. Toastmaster Karthik Venugopal. Toastmaster Sri Lakshmi Hegre.
Say hi.
Toastmaster Karthik, and here is Toastmaster Sri Lakshmi.
Hi.
And our distinguished Toastmaster Saurabh Datta. And the beauty queen who was in the news sometimes back, Toastmaster Reena Verma. The whole show was choreographed by and conceptualized by Toastmaster Reena Verma, and the tracks were prepared by our DTM Saurabh Datta. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you very much. Please take your seat. After the fashion show, time to welcome fashionista. A management graduate, a certified life coach, and an image professional with more than 15 years of experience in corporate leadership role. At Gabbys, we call her the silent killer because she truly believes in working in silence and letting success make all the noises. Please welcome our third table topic master for today, Toastmaster Preeti Shinagre, my darling namesake. Preeti, over to you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Preeti. Okay, so you guys have been having fun till now?
Yes.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, so let me start off. So today's round is going to be, I have some goodies. I have some objects in the bag. I'm going to put them in the bag. And you are just going to put your hand inside. Without seeing that object, you need to describe it at least for a minute. And the audience is going to recognize that and going to guess it. Right? Clear with the rules?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. Let's get started.
stand on one place.
So who's going first?
One quick question, Preeti, here.
Yes.
Are we supposed to guess the object?
Yes, you need to guess the object. So the person is going to describe that. For online people, I'm going to just put that word in the chat and then you can describe it.
Okay. And rest of us would be guessing the object.
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you.
What in the personal chat?
Yeah, in the personal chat. Yeah. So I'll be putting the name of the object for the in the personal chat for that person. For the online people. Okay? So that it's not visible to everybody. Clear? Okay. So could I have Vikram?
You just need to put your hand. You don't have to see the object. Just feel it. And whatever you can describe, you have to describe it.
All right, everyone. So this is something that is very important to keep things together, especially paper.
Paper clips.
Glue.
Stapler.
Very close.
Yeah. So it's something that we use to stick our papers and
cello tape.
Glue.
Cello
tape.
Cello tape.
Cello tape. Okay. Okay, so I would for the online, who's going to go next?
We have Toastmaster Suhan raising his hand.
So I need to type it here.
Yeah.
Who is it? Suhan.
Suhan wants to. So you want to give him directly?
Yeah, I'll just type the name for them. Yeah. Suhan, you got the answer?
Yes, I got it. You can hear me, right?
Yeah, yes. I can hear you.
Okay. This is an object where most of us like to get featured, mostly Facebook. Celebrities.
Phone?
Instagram.
No, it's an object. I didn't say it is a application. It's an object. We all get, we all get our photos clicked and
magazine.
Camera.
Oh yes, exactly. Okay. Someone said that.
Yeah, it's
magazine.
That's right.
Thank you.
Yeah, the next one is Shishti.
Yeah.
Okay. You can help me.
Don't make it easy, Shishti.
Yeah. Make at least speak for a minute.
Yeah.
So that the excitement doesn't.
And don't answer for
a we all wear these glasses. So what is the most convenient thing to keep it? We often forget to carry it and then we have to keep our glasses.
Are you saying this? The glasses? Are you saying this glasses?
The glass box.
Last case.
Yeah.
Oh, superb. Yeah, I have enough.
We have some more.
Sure. Okay, who's going online?
Do you want to call Sakshi?
Yeah, Sakshi.
Sakshi, are you there?
Actually, Sonia raised her hand.
Yeah, I'll call up Kamini.
Okay, after this, Sonia can.
Hi, Preeti.
Hi, Kamini. So this is.
Listen, there's a little bit of distraction in terms of the noise here. So I really don't know how well you'll be able to hear me, but could you just repeat how am I supposed to go about it? I wasn't able to hear that.
Okay, so the rules are, I'm going to type out a name okay, in the chat box, in your personal chat box. You need to read that and you need to describe it at least for a minute, and people are going to recognize that, or they're going to identify that, right?
Okay, cool.
Okay, yeah. So I'm just typing out the name for you. Yeah, here you go. Did you get it, Kamini? Check your chat box, please.
Okay, I got it, Preeti.
Okay, perfect. Now you can describe it for a minute, and the audience are going to identify what that object is.
So this is something which is seen in all of the kindergarten, play school areas. Kids absolutely love the dots on it. And it's pretty healthy for your overall... Am I audible?
Legos?
Yes.
Sorry?
Yes.
Legos.
No. So this looks like an umbrella. It looks like a cute little small umbrella. It grows in the ground and it's loaded with
mushroom.
Correct. You all were pretty good on it. So yeah, that's it. I can stop now, Preeti. Or do I have to go on?
That's it.
Mushroom.
Yeah, that's right. Mushroom is the right answer. Thank you so much, Kamini.
Thank you.
Okay, so the next person is Supriya. The object is... Yeah. Okay, your time starts now.
Yes, something related to our computers, laptops.
Mouse!
Yeah. Very easy!
Okay, one more is now.
Online, who's going next?
Sonia.
Somebody who hasn't taken up stage so far.
Chaitanya, how about Chaitanya?
Yes, I can take it up.
Yeah? Okay, Chaitanya. Okay, Chaitanya, I've sent you the name. Did you get it?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect.
It's a physical thing, but I'll just make it easy for you guys to guess the name. Something through which we order our groceries. It starts with
Zomato.
Phone, mobile phone.
Big basket.
Yeah, the second word is the correct one.
That was smart. Okay, so we have time or we are done? Yep.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. So a big round of applause for our table topic master, Toastmaster Preeti Shinagre. Thank you very much. It was a great change, isn't it? We're all good in guessing. I can see a lot of nods here. With this, I think we are towards the end of the session, and I would like to call our last table topic master. Yes, so did you notice something today in this hybrid meeting? We are seamlessly traveling, shuttling between Bangalore and the real world and the virtual world, logged in from different cities here. We had Nancy, logged in from Ludhiana, our timer Rani logging in from Lucknow, our second TTM Bala logging in from Singapore, and now our fourth TTM logging in from Hyderabad, but originally from the Pink City, Jaipur. Professionally a business analyst at a startup, Toastmaster Ayush likes reading books, traveling, writing, watching movies, and dancing. In short, he's living life to the fullest. Warm welcome, Toastmaster Ayush, and the stage is all yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Preeti. So, for this table topic section, you will have a situation where you have to be a particular thing that I would tell you. And there will be a catch. you would have to listen to a previous speaker and just add any element from their speech to yours. And so it might be easiest for the first volunteer who wants to come.
I will request Toastmaster Ayush to repeat the rules once again.
So I would be giving you a situation where you might be a thing that I tell you, and what you have to do is to include one of the elements from the previous person's speech. So attentively listen to your previous speaker, and you will have to include just one thing from them and speak on the topic I gave you. So I would request a volunteer who would like to start. Anyone from online or offline, anything you do.
You have to pick from the previous speakers, take a clue, and whatever topic he's giving, you have to continue using that clue to the next topic.
Okay, so since I would have volunteer, I will start with online first. Toastmaster Rani, would you like to go?
Yeah.
Me?
Yes.
So you'll be giving me an object and
what topic and on situation, because you don't have a previous speaker. The next speaker will have to listen to you carefully.
I'll
time you.
Okay.
So your topic is?
No worries, Rani. Okay. Toastmaster Lakshmi will show you the card here. So you can take this table topic.
You are a tiger in a desert. What will you do?
I'm a tiger in a desert. I will hunt for my prey. I will go here and there. I will search for water when it's heat. When I'm thirsty, I will spot, I might hide in some bushes and wait for my prey to come there. Maybe to drink water. I can be close to the bushes where there is water and the prey coming there to drink the water, and I can just pounce on my prey to eat. I can keep a watch from there on the little cubs playing beside me too. And that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Rani. So, anyone from offline, from in person?
Srishti.
Okay. So, Srishti. So, your topic is, you are a sun shining in Antarctica, where there is hardly anything. Your sun shining in Antarctica. Use one element from Rani's speech.
Can you repeat, Toastmaster Ayush? I'm a sun
shining over Antarctica.
Shining over Antarctica. Okay. You all love me when I come and you hate me when I don't. How does the mood feel when I don't show up for months? That is how you all feel in Antarctica. So in Antarctica, people literally pray me. They pray to God that please let the sun shine today so that it can lift our mood, make us a little more cheerful. Otherwise, it just becomes too gloomy. And you know what once happened? So there was a tiger in the bush. It was with the cubs and it was feeding them. And suddenly there was all darkness. The tiger thought that it's sunset so soon. What just happened? And then it started raining as well. The tiger realized that it's stuck. The children, how will it feed them? With no sun, no food, complete darkness, where can it go? And then it started praying to God. Luckily, I was just passing by and I heard the tiger prayer, and thus I shone brightly. brightly as I could. And you all should have seen the smile. Like, they were so happy to see me shine. They could find their way back. The tiger could feed the cubs. And happily, they all went. So this is how I can brighten up your mood, your day, your life. Thank you. I know what you know.
That was a great speech, Toastmasters. So I have one more topic. Who would like to come?
Yeah. Suhan.
Let's call someone who hasn't taken up the stage so far. Okay. Toastmaster Guru, would you like to take it up?
Yes, sir.
All right, Ayush, go ahead with me.
So you are a black line in a rainbow.
Could you please repeat one more time?
You are a black line in a rainbow.
Black line in the rainbow, is it?
Yes.
Thank you, Ayush. And first of all, wishing the second birthday for the Gabbys and also the 100th meeting. Really enjoying the entire meeting. And thanks for the invitation. And thanks for the table topic. See, normally, lion is one animal which will not go and hunt for anything. When it is hunger, it go for hunting. And it will not go and have everything and anything. So, always want to be a lion in any format. It could be in a rainbow, or it could be in a forest, or it could be in the market. When you want what exactly you want to have, either it could be the business, or it could be the fun, it could be the entertainment, you should hit the bullseye. So lion is one animal which has got that feeling, that attitude, that passion towards achieving the best out of it. So if you are talking about the black lion in the rainbow, so rainbow is the other part of the area where it talks about the nature, and it is the most beautiful thing in the nature. And the lion is the one which has got the strong attitude. So imagine the situation, and you are the black lion in the rainbow. So your dream, I think your imagination at the top. Thank you very much. Over to the table topic master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Guru Prasad. So that was from my side. Thank you again for your participation. Now, I'd like to hand the stage back to the PMOD, Toastmaster PT. Over to you.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Ayush. With this, we are almost towards the end of the session. And before that, I just wanted to hold this to give you a feel of what we are celebrating here in offline meeting. With this, I would like to ask any one of you, would you like to share, how did you feel today? How was the meeting today?
Ecstatic.
I'm asking the online guys here first. Toastmasters,
great, awesome.
Anyone? Please unmute yourself and just tell us one word or two words.
I'm having a kind of FOMO. I miss the
offline one. Anyone?
Exciting. The meeting was exciting and super amazing.
Funny, the meeting was not, the meeting is. It's still going on. Thank you very much. We are missing you, darling. Who else?
Yeah, I miss you all too.
It's great to see different versions of Gabbys, the inner talent. So much there, so much fun, so much exciting. Thanks.
Thank you, Toastmaster Bala. Here in offline, our area director is present. I would like to ask Toastmaster Prerna, how are you liking it here? What's your experience? Can you just come here and share it with us? Thank you very much. I wanted to receive it from your hand. Thank you very much. Yes.
It's been an amazing experience. I'm actually, to be very honest, like I mentioned in the starting of the meeting, that I'm speechless, because when I entered in here, when I just entered, I could just feel that vibe and that
energy. Oh, something happening!
Thank you.
Offline meeting is mute.
So a big round of applause for the dancers and the dreamers of the Gabbys today. Toastmaster, girls, the dancers, I want your attention, please. I want your attention, please. Yes, order. Yes, some excitement. They deserve it, isn't it? They have done a lot of hard work to enjoy this moment, to celebrate this moment. They really deserve it. But I would like to invite them on the screen. Very first dancer, Toastmaster Aparna Raja. Toastmaster Mitha Jain. Toastmaster Nishi Goel. Our president, Toastmaster Ritu George. Toastmaster Reena Verma. And our distinguished Toastmaster Saurabh Datta. Toastmaster Vikram Rao. Toastmaster Srishti Kedia. And finally, you have never seen this avatara of DGM Saurabh Datta. So the whole show has been choreographed by Rupa Pijathia. Thank you very much, guys. This was great fun. How was it? Make some noise online, guys. We are missing you here.
Oh my God, it was super amazing.
Yes, more, we want more.
Outstanding, incredible, utmost great, very good. You know, it was so well organized, and I would like to say that I was feeling like I am in cloud nine, because I was getting the feeling of like I'm in some international award show. And you people are so glamorous and you are so talented also. This I was getting the impression in the online meetings, but now I've you know, my God, I'm so fortunate to be attending today's meeting of yours. I wish you very, very many, many congratulations on your century, and may God bless you with so many centuries.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Sonia. Trust me, more of our applause and awards waiting for the Gabbys. We are on the way, we'll grab it very soon. And before we come to the end of the celebration and we do a formal cake cutting, I would like to invite our DTM, our past president, Toastmaster Saurabh Datta for a vote of thanks.
Thank you so much, all the Gabbys, Toastmasters, distinguished Toastmasters, Toastmaster leaders, and our guests. What went wrong today? What went wrong today? A lot of things went wrong. Right from the very beginning, we had an audio glitch. We had troubles with fixing the video. We had trouble connecting multiple devices. And what's one of the things that you saw today which you would never want to see again? Saurabh dancing. Right? I think I'm a horrible dancer. Period. Right? Now the question is, how bad are each of us as a speaker, as a grammarian, as an R counter? Are we even worse than what am I as a dancer? Definitely not, right? Definitely not. Each of you in your worst speech will be much better than my best dance performance. Absolutely correct? Right? No doubts?
No, we don't.
Tell me if I can take this challenge of dancing for the first ever time in my life in front of so many people. Something that I've never done before.
Wow.
What's holding you back? What's holding you back from making that speech, taking up the grammarian role, taking up the teamwork role, the general evaluator role? Apart from that excuse, I'm not good at it. Today, I want all of us to learn that there is nothing to be ashamed of in putting up a no show, putting up a bad show, because any show is better than a no show. So today on the 100th meeting, I would want all the Toastmasters of the Gabbys Club and every Toastmaster outside of the Gabbys as well to take a pledge that you will do justice to the membership that you have taken. You have to take a pledge that today we will continue to invest in our learning. Tell me why I could do the dance today and can I have order, please? Thank you. And I've never dared to do that before. What is different between Toastmaster and the world outside of Toastmaster? We have the same level of accountability, right? But here, if you fail, you don't lose a job. You don't lose an increment. Your relationships don't shake up. Imagine me going and trying to do a dance on a date, right? That would be the last time that person would see of me and I would see of her. But today I don't have that risk. I know I can come here, dance horribly, you will still clap for me because that's what the Toastmaster pride is all about. That is what the Gabbys pride is all about. This is why we started this club. We did not start this club for those awards there. They came by the way. They came on the way. We just grabbed them on the way. This award is not a recognition of our excellence. This is a recognition of us daring to try to be good. And I would want everyone here to remember that. Never lose sight of it. Why did we start the Gabbys? Why? Toastmaster doesn't solve world hunger. But Toastmaster serves the purpose of serving the hunger of knowledge, the hunger of finding a platform where we can come and fail horribly and still come back the next time. Yes, I will be dancing on the 150th meeting. Yes, I will be dancing on the 200th meeting. Because I know this is a platform where I can dare to fail. So let us end this meeting thanking ourselves for taking this pledge by joining the Gabbys Toastmasters Club. On behalf of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, the Gabbys Toastmasters Club Executive Committee, on behalf of Division B, District 92, on behalf of District 92, I thank the Gabbys Toastmasters Club for putting up the best show as the finest club that you can possibly be. I thank each and every member of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club for being an example for us when it comes to excellence, endurance, and empathy. We look up to you. We look up to you as a club to challenge us, to question us, to hold us accountable for what we are supposed to do as district officers, as Toastmaster leaders. And you never fail us. So thank you, all the Gabbys Toastmasters Club. The show today was possible because of the relentless effort of one person who from day one has been on top of things, from anything and everything that we have done today. It's thanks to her resilience, her constant follow-up. Yes, there was a time when many people would deliberately not pick up her calls because they knew that there's something pending. But that's okay. That's what she stands for, accountability. So let us welcome, let me thank Toastmaster Reena Verma. Of the best examples we have of resilience and accountability in the Gabbys Toastmasters Club. I would want to thank Toastmaster Preeti Chen. We'll be back to Toastmaster Ravi Jain for giving us this space. This place was available to us, courtesy Ravi and Preeti. Thank you so much, Preeti. We were able to do the first happy meeting. I would want to thank the president of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Ridley George, for keeping everything sane and keeping everything in control, for reminding us time and again that, guys, we have limitations, guys, this is what we can do, and constantly being behind me for things that I was responsible for. Because though I took a lot on my plate at the end, I was, you know, all over the place. And she was the one who ensured that I was on top of things. I would want to thank Toastmaster Aparna Raja, our Vice President, Public Relations, for the beautiful newsletter and her entire editorial team, and for the promotions that she has designed and launched for this particular program along with the PR team. I would want to thank our secretary, Toastmaster Dhwani Adhisara. The position of a secretary hardly goes recognized. It's one of those jobs where you do a lot of things and no one tells any good things about you, right? We're always stopping right at the four vice president. I can see all the past secretaries nodding their heads in agreement, right? Ask me about it. Okay. No wonder I was a secretary for only 1 week. Because when you don't get recognition, you don't find me, right? No, not really. So anyways, thank you so much, Toastmaster Dhwani Adhisara, for being on the top of things. I would want to thank Toastmaster Shrishti KD, our treasurer, for managing our finances so well. And finally, moving on has moved on to become the president. But our new Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Nishi Goyal, a wonderful team of officers we have at the Gabbys. I would want to thank each and every member of the Gabbys. You have taken part in the events, you have attended our rehearsals. There's been a lot of practice that you guys have done, the fashion show, the dance, the guitar. Lakshmi, thank you so much for the wonderful performance in the program. Coming back to what we have got this year, I would want to thank those people who have been the flag bearer of the Gabbys when it comes to awards, achievements, contests. Let me start with Toastmaster Lakshmi Sujata, who has represented our club and won at the area level for both evaluation speech contest and the international speech contest. Let me also congratulate and thank Toastmaster Aparna Raja for winning at the division level of Division E, District 92. We were earlier a part of Division E and becoming the first runner-up at the district level of District 92 in the International Speech Contest. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Aparna Raja. I would also want to thank and congratulate the three Grand Slam Master Mentors, four Grand Slam Master Mentors of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Nancy Goyal, Toastmaster Akanksha Srivastava, Toastmaster Sushmita Vaidya, and yours truly. I would also want to thank the three Spearhead Award winners of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Nancy Goyal, Toastmaster Sushmita Baidya, and yours truly. All of you have been examples and the heroes of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, representing us in various platforms and making us proud. Continue to do that. And finally, all the charter members of the Gabbys Toastmasters Club, we are here because you decided one day that we need to have a Toastmaster. Thank you, all the 23 people, wherever you are. We are on Facebook Live. I know you will be watching this event, whether you are a part of the club today or not. I would want you to know that we thank you from the bottom of our heart. And not only the charter members, even our past members, people who joined us on the day. With this, I would hand over the stage back to our Toastmaster of the day for the closing address, or should I close it?
You can close it, but it's okay.
Yes. So after this, we are going to do the cake cutting, which unfortunately can only be possible in a physical setting, but you do have our sweet wishes for the rest of the year and then for the rest of the term. Thank you so much. Thank you all the online participants who have joined us today. Thank you all the table topic masters and everyone who has taken up roles today. This meeting would not have been possible without you. Thank you. I hereby declare, no, I have had to go back to the presiding officer. Presiding officer, madam, you have to close the meeting, adjourn the meeting. No, we'll do the cake cutting after this because the online members will can't cut in the cake cutting. Or yeah, they can watch the cake cutting, right? So just stay on, guys. We'll do the closing after the cake cutting.
Everyone,
who's the youngest here?
Shrishti.
Officer, Toastmaster Ritu George, to adjourn the meeting. Thank you very much from my side. Bye bye.
Thank you, Toastmaster Preeti.
So for all those folks who are still here, do you want to stay back and watch us eat the cake or?
Okay, bye, Aparna. Bye, everybody.
I can't hear you. What?
Bye. Aparna, courier the cake to us. We'll be happy to eat.
Sorry?
Yes.
You know what we'll do? We'll show you the venue, what and all we've done for all the members who couldn't attend. All right? I'll show you. We have a photo booth and all. So that's the lectern, and that is where we did. Yeah, I'll show them. Yeah. So, of course, Reena has started her photo session, and then we have the boards. We have AB here. Hey, they haven't seen. Let them see.
I just show the venue.
Look at the awards that we won.
They see the decorations.
Hold on. Awards. They haven't seen the awards. These are just one set of awards. There is the next set of awards. We have close to 25 awards, if I'm not wrong. 25, I counted it. It's there in the newsletter. And this is the photo booth that we've set up.
And wait, I will pose with them.
There, see?
Wow, Reena is looking amazing.
Yeah.
So you're going to pause.
So we did all of that. And yeah. That's everyone.
Thank
guys,
you
say bye to them.
Thank you.
Guys, say bye, bye to all of us.
Bye.
See you next week.
See you next week on 17.
All right. I hope you guys also had some fun. Come, no, unmute.
Yes.
And start talking. Can't hear you.
Can you hear me, Aparna?
I can't hear you. Hold on. Yeah, can hear you now. Bolo?
You can hear me now?
Yes. We said this.
Finally. Oh, wow. The meeting was like top notch. I must say, you guys pulled an amazing show. And I am having major FOMO right now.
I know. So next time, just, you know what? Ayush, you're so close by. Come down. Hyderabad ho. Overnight hai. Come on. The other guys at least stay.
Actually, because of floods, I decided not to come. Otherwise, I would have come.
No worries. Come. So, hey, thanks, Sonia, for coming. Thank you, Shanti. I hope you guys had a great time. We had a great time.
Time to recover.
Fabulous
from
meeting.
Bye.
I can't imagine. I didn't imagine Saurav dancing.
You can't imagine Saurav dancing.
Exactly.
Even Saurav can't imagine Saurav dancing.
But, yeah.